Hi, welcome to Cofounder Collaboration Program. This is Chapter 5, Case Analysis. We will look into several situations that I've compiled from my experience and clients' experience and discuss how to work through each of those situations. In the material, when we will walk through, I assume that you have seen the previous chapters of the program. So if you haven't, then you might need to return back to chapter about alignment or setup or relating to get the necessary perspective. Let's start with the first one, relatively simple, but tends to repeat often. And this is when whatever you do is not enough for your co-founder or for other team member. And here, first we need to start by discriminating. Is it not enough or is it not correct according to their opinion? If it's not enough, then the next question is, what was agreed? Is it not enough according to agreement or not enough according to assumptions or expectations? And with agreement, I don't mean necessarily written agreement, but what was the decision that you agreed you need to deliver? Let's assume we are talking about the sales goal, that the sales goal wasn't reached. The agreement doesn't need to be necessarily put in writing, although it's good to park it somewhere. Even a Slack message can be considered parked somewhere in writing. An agreement has to have two things. First is that both have agreed to it. Second, both agreed that it is realistic and necessary to reach this. I've seen those types of agreements when one thinks that there was agreement, another thinks there was expectation. So then you cannot argue, was it enough or wasn't enough? Because first thing you need to get clear, is it enough or not enough according to the agreement? Now, what to do in case you don't have an agreement and there's this, it's not enough? Then it's very simple, actually. You just ask, okay, let's agree. What's the outcome we need to get? And then you negotiate until you agree on it. And then you go by this new agreement. In the course of the discussion, you might uncover that you cannot agree about something. And then a good starting point is to understand what exactly is that which you are not agreeing about. Then the next step is to understand, are you not agreeing about something you personally don't want to do or something that you think should not be done? Doesn't matter who is doing this, because in the second case, the solution is that you negotiate until you find a strategy or tactics that work for you both co-founders. But in the first scenario, you look for someone else who is doing it, unless you can really commit to doing it yourself. But next, just very practical situation can be that you had agreement, you did not reach what was agreed, and now you get the confrontation that it is not enough. Well, in this situation, you assess, is it realistic for you to reach this goal? Maybe you are just in the passenger mode, and if it is, then take the confrontation, accept it, and go and do it, do your work. But if it's not doable, meaning, let's assume that you reflect and you see it's not an achievable goal. In such a case, you need to renegotiate either the goal or the resources available. Address this situation not in terms of we have a conflict that I don't like, that it's never enough for you, but there's a very realistic problem that we are not reaching a goal that is necessary to reach. But then the next situation is this opposite. When I have reached the goal and it's not enough for you, what to do then? First of all, you just remind that we agreed that this is the goal. This is reached or slightly above, so it is enough and that's it. And if the other person is like, yeah, but you could have tried more and then there was more potential, you just take it all as input. Be calm, you have reached the goal. But if this continues, then that might be signaling that maybe for the other person the goal is too low. And then you see that maybe you need to renegotiate the goal instead. But where this discussion leads more often is not so much about not enough, but not correct. And exactly this not correct is the one which creates tension and irritation in the team. And how to address this it's not correct situation, you know, when like, yes, this, but why you didn't do it this way, or why this is not that way, or I don't like this part. To address it, you need to know where you stand in which of two positions. Are you the main responsible person for the thing you are discussing? Or the other person is the main responsible person and you are part of the project team. First, when you are the main responsible person and you are looking at something that you have made, created, the output. And this output is not necessary for their work. It's just part of your work. Let's say you are marketing director, and then there's a banner, and then the CEO is saying that this banner is ugly. You should, in your energy, be as the main responsible person and treat that what you are hearing as opinion than order. So you can say that, thank you for your feedback, I will take it into account, and that's it. Because what you are accountable for is not how does the CEO like or not like the banner. What you are accountable for is the number of inbound leads that you generate or some other KPI that you have agreed upon. And the problem or the mistake that is happening here sometimes is that the main responsible person treats the other person's input and opinion as order. And that happens sometimes because this other person by structure is in a role above us. So let's say I'm the CMO co-founder and you are the CEO co-founder, and then you are annoyed with how the banner looks, and I psychologically cannot perceive it as feedback, as opinion. I'm perceiving it as order, and then I get annoyed. Why are you interfering in my things? But sometimes there can be exactly this, that they are interfering. They are coming and saying, do this way, and why don't you choose this software for making this banner, and so on. And then you may even push back saying that this is all just methods and thanks for your opinion, but we are all fine here. We are fine. Although sometimes these opinions and inputs and feedbacks can be good, they can be supportive. Just don't forget to verify, where do you stand? Is it opinion or is it order? Completely different thing is when they are the main responsible person and then they are telling you something which is necessary for their work. So let's say now your co-founder is the CEO who needs from you, the CMO, some analytics data for the financial planning when preparing the investor report. So they are responsible for the investor report, and then they need this data from you. And let's say they ask from you 5 pieces of data points and you give them 4, and you consider that's enough and that's fine because the 5th is quite hard to get. So, but then they say it's incorrect what you gave me, I need 5, not 4. And what you, in this case, you can do, you can negotiate a bit. You can ask, okay, but is it really necessary? And why is it necessary? Because to get this 5th, it's additional 2 days of work for us to gather this data. So negotiate until you understand why he needs that and why for you is hard or a big effort to get this data, until you come to conclusion that works for both. But to conclude this topic, this situation of someone being constantly unhappy with not enough or not correct, it also highlights something else. It highlights that this mostly unhappy person might be a controller type. So he's micromanaging. That means he's intervening in the methods. And then what you do, you always just push back the discussion to the level of outputs and outcomes. Or you just say thank you for the feedback and opinion and go your own way. Or the other thing is that you are different types of personalities. Let's say one is a detailed thinker, another is fast thinker, or one is very structured thinker, another is more relationship type person. And in this case, you are learning from each other. You can always find the middle ground if you negotiate respectfully between yourselves. But then there can be a question, okay, but if it's still annoying, it's all the time happening and I'm getting annoyed and I'm feeling unappreciated and disrespected, let's cover it in the next situation analysis. And second situation,